Thanks to the development of technology, the exhaust emissions from motor vehicles have dropped significantly over recent decades. Hybrid cars are powered by an internal combustion engine and one or more electric motors, which uses energy stored in batteries. These greener vehicles allow drivers to experience their more improved fuel economy than conventional cars. Before going in details, first we'll discuss about the history of hybrid cars. The first hybrid car wasn't the Toyota Prius or the Honda Insight, nor was it invented in the 1990s or 2000s. In fact, it dates back to the early 20th century. The first hybrid car was in part the brainchild of a Viennese coach builder named Jacob Lohner, who felt that gas-driven cars were too noisy and smelly. To find a solution to this problem, Lohner turned to a young Austrian engineer named Ferdinand and Porsche. The first hybrid car was built in the year 1899 by engineer Ferdinand and Porsche, called the system Lohner-Porsche Mixed. It used a gasoline engine to supply power to an electric motor that drove the car's front wheels. The Mixed was well received, and over 300 were produced. The demand for hybrids began to wane. However, when Henry Ford started the first automobile assembly line in 1904, Ford's ability to produce gasoline-powered cars and offer them at low prices dramatically shrunk the hybrid vehicle market. The interest in the hybrid car renewed somewhere in the 1960s, when the United States Congress introduced the legislation which stated the importance of electric and hybrid vehicles as the gasoline engine was more prone to generate pollution. The actual demand for hybrid cars increased in the year 1973 due to the Arab oil embargo. In 1997, Toyota introduced the Prius in Japan. In the United States of America, Honda Insight was the first HEV that was mass-produced in 1999. It was the Toyota Prius that gave rebirth to the hybrid cars, and people started demanding it. The main reason the Prius got so famous in America was mainly due to its eco-friendly nature and one of the best-in-class fuel economy which it gave to the masses. The Insight, which was produced by Honda, was not as successful as the Prius, but it did give good competition. Now coming to the topic of hybrid electric vehicles parts and its working. A hybrid car uses more than one means of energy, combining a petrol or diesel engine with an electric motor, and the two systems work with each other to move the vehicle. This allows the car to burn less gasoline, achieving better fuel efficiency than a traditional engine that solely uses fuel does. Electric power serves to boost the performance of the engine. In a hybrid car, the system recollects energy via regenerative braking and by the internal combustion engine. The operating mode can be changed and shifted while driving, which means the car can alter between a gas engine and an electric motor. Sometimes, it can use both to enhance the car's performance. What is regenerative braking? Hybrids and all electric vehicles create their own power for battery recharging through a process known as regenerative braking. In a conventional braking system, when you step on a vehicle's brake pedal, the discs and the brake pads create friction as they meet. In turn, the friction creates kinetic energy that dissipates into the environment in the form of heat and becomes useless. Every time you step on your car's brakes, you're wasting energy. Regenerative braking is an energy recovery mechanism that slows down a moving vehicle or object by converting its kinetic energy into a form that can be either used immediately or stored until needed. In this mechanism, the electric traction motor uses the vehicle's momentum to recover energy that would otherwise be lost to the brake discs as heat. There are two conditions when regeneration occurs: number one, when the driver applies the brake pedal, and number two, when the driver releases the accelerator pedal and the vehicle is coasting. In both cases, the system creates electricity to recharge the battery. Drivers can view this regenerative effect on the vehicle's charging gauge, which shows it as energy flowing from the wheels to the battery. To know how hybrid cars works, you must understand the structure and main components of a hybrid electric vehicle. The structure of the hybrid car consists of different components, which are as follow: auxiliary and traction battery pack. In the vehicle, the low-voltage auxiliary battery delivers electricity to start the vehicle before activating the traction battery, and it also provides power to the vehicle accessories, while the traction battery stores power for use by the electric traction motor. DC converter. DC converter transforms higher voltage DC power from the traction battery pack into the lower voltage DC power required to operate the vehicle's accessories and recharge the auxiliary battery. Electric generator. The electric generator is like an electric motor, but it only works to generate electrical power from the wheels, which turn when braking, and then transfer this energy to the traction battery. Some vehicles use a motor generator that performs both drive and regenerative functions. It usually used in series hybrids. Electric traction motor. A hybrid vehicle has a highly developed electric motor. It can work as both a generator and a motor thanks to advanced circuitry. It can use the power of the traction battery pack to drive the wheels of the car. Exhaust system. The exhaust system sends the engine's exhaust gases out of the tailpipe. The exhaust system has a three-way catalyst converter to lower engine out emissions. Internal combustion engine. The fuel injected from the fuel tank into the combustion chamber, where it mixes with the air, and this air-fuel mixture has burned. Power electronics controller. This component of the hybrid vehicle manages the traction battery's electrical energy flow and regulates the torque and speed of the traction motor. Thermal system. It maintains a suitable operating temperature range for power electronics, electric motors, hybrid engines, and all other parts. Transmission. A hybrid vehicle's transmission serves the same basic function as a traditional vehicle's transmission. It converts mechanical power from the engine or electric traction motor to drive the wheels. Let's see the scenarios for the hybrid car working procedure. From the basic concept, we understand that hybrid car consists of engine and battery both. In that starting of this type of cars, electric motor helps to move the car by taking power from the battery, or in some cases car can be moved by IC engine. After starting of the car, it speeds up and starts to move normally. During the normal driving, both engine and motor can work simultaneously, or only one can work at normal speeds. If high speed is required, driver needs to accelerate the car. In this scenario, engine gives more power and more speeds with respect to battery. Hence, for high speed and acceleration, engine works mainly. Mostly the speed below or up to 30 miles per hour. A car will be in hybrid mood, while above 30 the car should run on fuel. During braking of the hybrid car, no power will be provided for optimization. When the car stopped, both motor and engine are turned off to save the fuel as well as battery power. During normal driving, battery is charged and all accessories like lights etc. are running from the battery. What happens if a hybrid car runs out of battery power? If the battery is out of power, the vehicle will automatically switch over to the IC engine drive and use petrol or diesel to continue running. It will then also start charging the battery back up again on its own. This means that as long as you have fuel in your vehicle, you won't have to worry about the battery charge. What happens if a hybrid car runs out of gas? It depends on the car. If your hybrid runs out of gas, you might assume that giant battery will help you out. However, most hybrid engines simply weren't designed to operate on electricity alone. They aren't electric cars after all. The gas engine and propulsion battery are engineered to work in tandem, not on their own. Every hybrid engine runs a little differently, so every hybrid vehicle will respond to an empty gas tank in a different way. Some hybrid vehicles, like the Chevy Tahoe and Nissan Altima, won't operate at all once their gas tank is empty. even if the battery is fully charged. That's because running the engine on electricity alone can cause severe damage to the hybrid system. Run out of gas in these cars, and you'll just need to call a tow or set out for the nearest gas station on foot. Many hybrids can drive for a short distance just on the electric motor portion of the hybrid system. Some cannot. In general, you will have time to pull over to the side of the road and deal with an empty tank, the same way a gasoline-only car would. The advantages of a hybrid car are environmental friendliness. Hybrid cars house a gasoline engine and an electric motor, resulting in less dependence on fossil fuels and producing low CO2 emissions. Financial benefits. Many tax credits and incentives are available to make hybrid cars more affordable. Regenerative braking system. The energy from the motion of applying the brake is captured and used to recharge the battery. Such a system allows you to eliminate the amount of time for regularly recharging the battery. Higher resale value. With the growing popularity, hybrids' resale value is higher than the average. While the disadvantages of a hybrid car is higher costs than a regular gasoline car, less power. The power of a combination of a gasoline engine and an electric motor in hybrid cars is less than that of a gas-powered engine in many cases. Poorer handling. Hybrid vehicles have more machinery than regular cars do. Manufacturers' attempts to avoid extra weight in vehicles result in smaller motor and battery in addition to reduced support in the suspension and body. High-voltage batteries. In case of an accident, the presence of the high voltage increases the risk of the passengers being electrocuted and makes the rescuer's task more difficult. Higher maintenance costs. Its technology requires higher costs for maintenance. And battery replacement is pricey. The types of the hybrid electric vehicles is in part 2 of this video. Thanks for watching the video. For more videos, subscribe to my channel.